What are wildfires and how do they spread? Wildfires are uncontrolled fires that occur in forests, grasslands, and brushland that spread quickly and can destroy the surrounding environment. It all starts with a spark. This spark can be any number of things: the sun, lightning, embers blowing from a campfire, or most often, human error. Recent studies have found that approximately 84% of wildfires are caused by human errors. However, a spark alone will not start a wildfire. Wildfires require three components: a heat source, fuel, and oxygen, called the fire triangle. A heat source is required to generate ignition. This is our spark. The spark feeds on material to burn, known as fuel. Fuel can come in the form of dead or dry grasses, trees, or leaves. As these fuels burn, the flames feed off the surrounding oxygen, which is needed to sustain the combustion process. Oxygen reacts with the burning fuel to release heat and CO2. Wildfires are destructive forces, but have been occurring naturally for centuries. Although counterintuitive, wildfires that burn up plant life and endanger animals promote ecological health. These periodic fires help clear out dead organic materials that begin to build up on the ground and prevent organisms from accessing the nutrients in the soil. The dead organic matter can also choke out the growth of smaller new plants. These ecosystems require periodic fires to survive and reproduce. Prescribed burns can mimic the benefits of wildfires while also lowering the risks associated with larger uncontrolled fires. While these burns still have the potential to become dangerous and out of control, they are well planned and performed with trained professionals. However, this does not mean that there are no negative effects of wildfires. Excessive wildfires kill and displace wildlife, alter water cycles and the soil fertility, and endanger the lives of local communities. Soil can be damaged severely by too much burning and heat, which can cause soil particles to become hydrophobic, causing more erosion. In recent years, wildfires have been at an all-time high. Since 2015, there has been an increase of approximately 100 wildfires per year in the United States alone. What is the cause of this sudden increase? The answer? Climate change. Climate change feeds into all the factors that create perfect fire conditions. It increases the risk of wildfires by causing vegetation to dry out, creating more fuel. This is especially true for regions like the western United States, which have seen an increase in extreme fire seasons in recent years and extended periods of drought. As global temperatures increase, the rate of evaporation also increases. This causes moisture to be drawn out from the plants and the land, so when the initial spark occurs, there is ample fuel ready to ignite and spread quickly over large areas. This effect causes a positive feedback loop. Climate change has caused temperatures to rise and dry out land and vegetation, which causes a higher rate of wildfires. The more wildfires there are, the more that CO2 is emitted into the atmosphere, which feeds to an increased climate change and increased temperatures. It's a continuous cycle. Climate change will continue to drive rising temperatures and droughts, which will cause even more wildfires in the coming decades. So what can be done? The first steps will be to build resilience against these wildfires. The likelihood and impact of wildfires can be reduced by increasing the space between structures and nearby fuel, removing fuels from environments that are at risk, executing periodic controlled burns, and developing recovery plans for before and after a fire hits. However, all these steps can only lower the impact of wildfires, but they will not stop climate change. Without climate change being addressed, temperatures will continue to increase and will continue to feed into the wildfire cycle. So what will you do to slow the effect of climate change and help limit wildfires?